by Johnson's Wax, makers of clear, self-polishing floor wax that dries clear as glass, never yellows. And now, let's all play What's My Line? From New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
On my left, one of the finest actors of the stage and screen, and also too much, Mr. Louis Jourdan.
And on my left, a very lovely, lovely, lovely lady who just opened in Beekman Place in Paramus, New Jersey, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now all the birds are flying south. And the leading cuckoo of them all is our charming publisher panelist, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I heard all the screams of delight for Louis Jourdan, and we believe in equal time on television. So I would like the same screams for good old John Charles Daly.
Yes, it's better than being cuckoo. Cuckoo. Mr. Jourdan, very nice to have you with us on the panel.
Thank you. It's a pleasure for me.
I will tell you all, we have some very interesting occupations for you to puzzle with. We will also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program, but we'll meet our first challenger after this word. And now to meet our first challenger, will you enter and sign in, please? Edie? May? Coots. Right, ma'am?
All righty. Is it Miss or Mrs. Coots?
Mrs.
Mrs. Coots, mm-hmm. Where are you from?
Houston, Texas.
Houston, Texas.
Yes.
Nice to have you with us. And you have some friends from Houston, Texas,
yes,
in our audience. Mrs. Coots, may I present our panel?
I do.
Now, will you join me over here? And we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, we can tell you that Mrs. Coontz is self-employed and deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Mrs. Coontz, I know there's a branch of that cheap notion store, Neiman Marcus, in Houston. Can I eliminate Neiman Marcus from your activities entirely?
Yes.
Is the service that you perform one that is done for both sexes?
It could be.
Could be, yes.
Is it a service that requires you in any way to come in physical contact with the people for whom you perform said service?
No.
One down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mrs. Coontz, could anyone on this panel use your services?
Yes.
In the right time and place, I mean.
Yes, it would require a set of circumstances that would make the service viable and reasonable, but you certainly could use this service if you need it.
Would you consider this service not unpleasant?
It is not unpleasant.
No. Yes, no. It is not.
Yes, would you say that one sex more than the other tended to need the service?
I would think we could agree that in engaging the service, it is likely that one sex more than the other would be the engaging party to use the service, yes.
Are animals
or children ever involved with this service?
No. No. Two down and eight to go, Mr. Jourdain.
Mrs. Coutts, do you think that I have used such services before?
No.
No, I don't think so. We might be wrong.
Possibly,
and you can...
Possibly, but I don't.
I would say no. It would mislead you if we gave you any other answer, I'm afraid. That's three down and seven to go, Miss France.
Miss Coutts, do you go to the person's house to perform your service?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Would they be liable to call you if they wanted your service?
Yes.
Do you wear something other than the ordinary dress when you perform your service?
Ordinary work clothes, yes.
Are you ever in contact with the kitchen when you...
Excuse me, is that a yes or a no? She said ordinary work clothes. Arlene said something other.
Well,
yes,
Mrs.
Other
Coutts
than
is not wearing ordinary
work
clothes.
Other than street clothes, yes.
Okay. Mrs. Coutts, would you ever be in contact with the kitchen while you're performing your service?
No.
Four down and six to go, Mr. Serf.
Mrs. Coons, do you either improve or rectify some defect in the service that you perform?
Yes, I would say that as a result of the service, there is a definite improvement to the area to which the service has been directly applied.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. The improvement, since you don't touch people, must be to the premises rather than to the people who demand your services. Is that correct?
Yes.
Have you got anything to do with either electrical fixtures or plumbing fixtures?
No, sir.
That's five down and five to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you have anything to do with the living quarters of the house as opposed to the kitchen, bathrooms, etc.?
No.
Nope. Six down and four to go, Mr. Jourdain.
Do you have anything to do with the show business? Something to do with in which you help perhaps an actor or... No, this is a very
bad
question.
Seven down and three to go, Miss Francis.
I'm completely at a loss. I'm very bad.
Your voice is so gentle, Mr. Jourdain, it couldn't matter less what you ask. I don't care whether you get a yes or a no, as long as you stay with me.
Let's get our mind back on our work.
What?
Let's get our mind back on our work.
Yes. Mind back to business. If you do not ever come in contact with the person deliberately, or you do not come in contact with the premises, is that what Mr. Cerf...
No, the agreement was that not coming in direct contact with individuals, we would agree that there is a contact with the general area known as the premises.
I see. Is there something specific in the home that you might have something to do with?
Eight down and two to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, Mrs. Coontz, I must presume then that what you have reference to is outside the home. Is that correct?
Yes.
Would it be the grounds surrounding the home, possibly, that you have something to do with?
No, not the grounds. That's nine
not
down and one to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, is it the outside of the house itself?
No, that's ten down and none to go. No more to go.
The painter.
No, that she'd
no.
be
well,
the
actually,
outside of the house.
You're right about the painting, but a very particular kind of painting.
Telegraph poles. What?
Well, flag poles.
Oh, flag poles.
Steeplejack. That's what Mrs. Coates did.
Well,
flag poles, smokestacks, water towers. Mrs. Coates has been doing it for 20 years. And she said it's very easy. Well, you sand them going up and you paint them coming down. And once upon a time, Mrs. Coontz was asked, is there any secret, you know? And that she said, was the secret was you send them going up and you paint them coming down. And then somebody said, well, why do you do it? And she said, just for the heck of it.
Do you ever fall off, Mrs. Coontz?
Beg your pardon?
Do you ever fall down? Do you ever fall off?
No, and I hope I never do.
Okay.
I'm not allowed that one mistake.
No, that's not allowed. I must say, we hope you never do. And
sure.
Thank you for puzzling our panel with your occupation.
Thank
nice
you
to have you with us.
Very nice.
Great way to start the new year would be to make a steeplejack out of Bennett, too. Now let's see what we can do with a new challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? Noel Levine, right, sir? Good show. All right. Mr. Levine, where do you come from?
Hewlett Bay Park, New York.
Hewlett Bay Park, New York. Makes you a neighbor. All right, Mr. Levine, may I present the panel? Yeah. And you join me over here. We'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Now, panel, we will tell you that Mr. Levine is self-employed and deals in a product. And we'll begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Mr. Levine, could I use your product?
Yes.
Could I hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Would it be likely?
Yes.
Is it solid rather than liquid?
Yes.
Is it something that would be found in the home?
Yes.
Is it something that might be found in the kitchen?
No.
No. One down and nine to go, Mr. Jourdain.
Is it something that one might find in a bedroom?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Nice try, though. You don't want to say what you had in mind.
No.
Is it something that is useful rather than decorative?
Yes, we would have to agree it's useful.
Mm-hmm.
Is it something that has moving parts?
No.
That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
You've eliminated, Mr. Levine, the kitchen and the bedroom, leaving the living room, the bathroom, the attic, and the cellar, right?
I left out the dining room.
The dining room. Might it be found in the living room?
No.
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are we sure that this is found in the house at all?
Oh, yes.
Oh, it is.
Yes.
If it is in the house, would it be likely to be put away somewhere rather than displayed on the coffee table?
No.
Well, this is a difficult question. Are you asking specifically, would this ever be displayed on the coffee table?
No.
Oh, that's fine. That gives you a no.
Well, he said it wouldn't be in the living room. Where's the coffee table in your house?
I keep it in the closet because, you see, we're very crowded.
Well, John, just to straighten me, I don't want a yes. Just straighten me out.
Well, now, what is it you really want to get at? Is this something that would be put away, or would it be on view if you were in the area where it was normally used? Is that your question?
I guess that's what I want.
Well, on that basis, we will give you a yes. With Mr. Levine's permission, we'll agree that it is not put away. It is
used. It would be on view. I think I cheated you, but anyway, I'll accept. It would be on view if you were in the right place in the house.
Yeah.
Which isn't easy to find.
Yes.
It's not the living room. It's not the kitchen. It's not the bathroom. It's not the bedroom.
You are assuming some things here, which, of course, you've taken out of previous questioning.
Right.
If you should be in error, you know this would be wrong.
Oh, well, then don't answer that question. Tear it up, and I'll get my no right away. Could it be found in the bathroom?
Yes.
Thank you, Louis. And I could hold it in my hand.
Who said that?
I did. I could hold it in my hand, couldn't I?
Mm-hmm.
Is it squashy?
Squashy? No, it's not squashy. That's five down and five to go, Mr. Jourdain.
Now, do you use this product on your body?
No.
No. Six down and four to go, Miss Francis.
Why was everybody squealing? Somebody out there uses it on their body somewhere. Now, when you say, could it be used on the body, you are including the mouth and the face and all that, aren't
you?
Oh,
certainly.
Because that's all part of the body.
Okay.
That last time I looked, it was. Yeah.
In the bathroom. It gets so difficult, doesn't it, after a while? Is it something that you would have to get for your bathroom by contacting a plumber rather than a drugstore?
No. Seven down, three to go, Mr. Sir.
Oh,
Mr. Levine, can we rule out medicine of any kind in this thing?
Have to.
Yes.
Is it anything used to clean the bathroom or cleanse it or get it rid of things that you don't want in the bathroom?
Don't bother, Bennett. You blew it already. Oh. That's eight down. Two to go, Miss Kilgallen.
May I eliminate toothbrushes of all kinds?
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
as well as
body.
Soap. Yeah, well, I figured. But I just don't know. It's not a sponge, or it would be squashy. And that's the body, too.
Can't be a bathroom scale.
If it is found in the bathroom, would it be found closer to the floor than to the ceiling?
That's a very good question. Yeah, I would agree that you'd likely find it closer to the floor than the ceiling. Unless you have a very small house.
No, everything comes in contact with the body.
Well, all right, I throw the towel in for you.
That comes in contact with the body, John.
What towel?
Any towel.
Not a shower curtain.
Well, of course it does.
Oh, no.
Of course it does.
Any contact. Actually, something new has happened. Bennett hasn't caught up with it. I can remember the old showers, you know, where you'd stand under a ring and then you'd pull the shower curtain around, and you were in contact all the time then. But we have this new invention, Bennett. It's a long pole, and you put the shower curtain on.
How do you pull the curtain back with your hand, or is it done electrically?
Yeah, but the question was posed in the context of applying it to the body, and there certainly is no issue here, except Bennett might do this. You wouldn't take a shower curtain and apply it to the body like so.
The new year is coming up. Why don't you make a couple of resolutions?
I will. Let's get together. No, that's it. It's shower curtains. Actually, you are the president of Hygiene Industries.
Yes.
One of the biggest shower curtain makers in the United States of America. And we're very pleased that you stuck the panel. And thank you very much, Mr.
John,
Levine.
Thank you very much.
We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment. And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which, as you know, the panel is always blindfolded. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Good. Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? Panel, in this case, we go to a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Mr. Jourdan.
Well, judging from those fabulous applause, I would ask the first question that way. You are most obviously from the show business, aren't you?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
But he wants to keep quiet about it.
Are you best known to this vast and approving audience for your work in pictures?
Yes.
Mr. Cerf?
Do you ever raise your undoubtedly louder voice and work in song in the pictures that you perform in?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
Did I ever buy you a tie?
Did you ever what, Dorothy?
Buy him a tie.
Yes.
Mr. Jourdan?
Do I know you personally?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Well, Dorothy must have bought more than one fellow a tie. Are you now appearing in a picture on Broadway, or are you about to in the very near future?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Cerf.
Have you appeared within the past 2 months in a nightclub or a hotel in the New York area?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
My big chance. Have you ever lost your address book in a helicopter over the Greek islands?
Your frames of reference are so gorgeous, I don't care what.
That's no. That's 3 down and 7 to go.
Well, then I do know who it is. Well, no, I don't.
Mr. Jourdan?
Can I ask a direct question? I think I have an idea of who it is. Can I do it?
If you have an idea who it is, try the name and see what happens.
Are you Gene Kelly?
Yeah! Exactly. Dorothy, just for fun, whom did you have in mind?
Tony Perkins.
Tony Perkins.
Or Gardner McKay.
Or Gardner McKay. Well, you buy a lot of neckties. That's all we got to say at this point. But you kind of recovered,
Paddle. Why do they all lose notebooks when they're with you?
So we'll give you some congratulations. We'll have another contestant after this word. And now, a final challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Glenn? Kaufman. Is that right? All right. Mr. Kaufman, where are you from, sir?
Wayne, New Jersey.
I beg your pardon?
Wayne, New Jersey.
Wayne, New Jersey. Now, I think we will admit to the panel that you have not as yet completed your education. You're still attending school, but we are concerned with extracurricular activity with which he earns a stipend when he does what he does. And now, may I present Mr. Kaufman, our panel. And now, will you join me over here? And we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Let me get this squared away for you. Oof, we go. How's that? Panel, we can tell you that Master Kaufman is self-employed and deals in a service, and we'll begin everything with Arlene Francis.
Well, Mr. Kaufman, I congratulate you in the first place for earning a living at such an early age. I'm in favor of that. And may I ask, could I use your service?
Yes.
Do you deal with people that live in houses or apartments in your service?
Yes.
Do you go from door to door ever when you are in the service of your service?
No.
No, that's one down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Wayne, may I presume that you have never lost your notebook with Dorothy Kilgallen? Wayne, have you got anything whatever to do with show business or music?
Yes.
It's Glenn Bennett. I'm sorry. It's from
Mr.
Wayne, New Jersey.
Oh.
Glenn. Glenn, may I call you Glenn? Is it all right to call you Glenn?
Yes.
Glenn, is it music that you have something to do with?
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you appear on the stage, radio, or television?
Yes.
Do you appear on the... No, it's a side job. Oh. Well, he'd go to school, too. Excuse me, I'm just thinking aloud. Do you ever appear on the stage?
Yes.
Are you currently appearing in a Broadway musical?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Jordan.
When is the last time that you appeared?
Questions have to be answered yes or no.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you act in pictures?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
No, did Dorothy have it right when she said the stage?
Mm-hmm.
That is it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, I hate to think of you being out of work, like as most actors are most of the time. But are you in something that has not opened yet? Are you rehearsing in something that's about to be presented?
No.
No. Our time is running out, so I will flip all the cards over, which I think is a great idea for Glenn anyway. I want to introduce you to 1 9-year-old excellent professional magician. It's a wee bit early, but certainly not too early to say Happy New Year to all of you. Mr. Jordan, nice to have you with us, and I hope the New Year brings many great and lovely gifts to you. And good night, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Same to you, John. Good night, Dewey. Come
good
again.
Night. Good night.
Look forward to having you back in New York in the theater, Louis.
Thank you very much.
And that'll be a happy new year for all of us and to all of you.
The same to you all. And, John, I would have given Glenn a lot to see if he could make you disappear.
Great way to wind up a year. That's all I got to say. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us on What's My Line and Happy New Year.
The CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Todman. This is Johnny Olson speaking. The program was pre-recorded. By the way, if you'd like to attend one of our broadcasts, write to What's My Line, CBS Tickets, 485 Madison Avenue, New York, New York, 10022.